Welcome to Tech Primus. In this video, we are going to see how to create a Spring Boot application with a Spring MVC using Kotlin. So if you had seen my previous video, so Kotlin is a new language which is running over the JVM. The new buzz is that Android has announced first class support for Kotlin. That's why we are learning Kotlin. So I also started learning Kotlin in the recent days. I already know Groovy. Let me know if you want me to make any videos about Groovy. But I use Groovy for writing test cases at work. But yeah, in this particular video, we're going to see how to create a Spring Boot application using Kotlin. Okay. So let's go ahead and create a project. So as usual, I'm going to the Spring Initializer. I'm just creating a project called, let's say the package name is Kotlin. Kotlin Learning. Okay, so what do we need is we need Spring MVC, we need Spring JPA, and let's create some in-memory database. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a basic Spring Boot application which is going to have a H2 database, and I'm going to use Spring JPA to inject the data into H2 database and get it back. Okay, and I'm going to expose this as a form of REST endpoint. So we are going to use Spring MVC for that. Okay, so I have marked the project as Kotlin. Okay, so let's generate this project and we'll see how to write a Spring application using Kotlin. So if you had seen my previous video about Spring Boot, so I would have just created a users repository. I would have just created a users REST endpoint. I just would have exposed that and then we would have just updated it. So we are going to do the same thing but using Kotlin. Okay, so the project is open. Let me open the project in IntelliJ. Okay. Yeah, the project is open here. So if you notice here, the project structure is almost similar to Java, but just a little bit of a change. Instead of Java, it is Kotlin, and same way the file extension, if you notice, it is .kt. Okay. If you have seen my previous video about the introduction to Kotlin, I would have showed you some basic commands of how to create functions. If you are not aware about Kotlin, just I would suggest you go and check that video and then come back again so that you will know about Kotlin. So what is Kotlin and why Kotlin is doing something different in a way Java is doing. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a resource. So I'm going to create basically a REST endpoint. I'm going to create a package first. So if you had seen all my videos, I would have created similar example, right? Users example. So I'm going to use the same thing. So I'm going to create a users resource. I'm just saying class. Okay. So in this particular users resource, what I need is I need to expose this as a REST endpoint. So the annotations are almost the same thing because those are coming from Spring, right? So it's a REST controller, and I'm going to say request mapping. Okay. So REST/users. We need to create a REST endpoint called get mapping, and if you notice how to write function in Kotlin is you need to say function and then you need to say what is the name of the function. So I'm going to say get users. Okay, and then you have to say what is the return type by this notion. So you have to say colon and then I'm going to say list of users. I wanted users. Okay, so let's go ahead and create the users. Okay, so if you see here, I'm creating the users here itself. In fact, it's not required to be created outside, but it's a small class. It's going to be a small class, so that's why I'm creating here itself. So we need to mark this as entity. Okay, I'm just marking this as entity. And another thing is you need to create variables, right? So what you can do is you can do this. So you can say I need name, which is going to be a string. Okay, and I need salary, which is going to be integer. In fact, you can assign the variables here directly. So the default variables, you need to assign something. So I'm just assigning here. And finally, I need a value ID, okay, which is going to be long, and I'm just assigning it as 0. So this particular ID, I need to generate it every time. So I'm just going to annotate it with the usual generated value. Okay, so I'm just saying strategy auto. Okay, this is the normal Spring JPA annotation, JPA annotations basically. Okay, so what I have done is this is a POJO. So this is how you create a POJO or entity basically in Kotlin. So I don't have to do anything. So I can give the variable names in the constructor argument itself, like how we create a constructor. So if you see here, I'm not using any getters, I'm not using any setters. So you don't have to do that. So by default, Kotlin generates them for you. Okay, so now our users are ready. Next, what we need is the users repository. So in order to get the users repository, you can create, I can create it here itself. I'll say interface users repository. And to extend, I just need to do a colon. Okay, and I say JPA repository. What type of object I need is users, and what is the primary key is long. ID is the primary key, right? So that's it. So if you notice here, that's all. I just need to do this. I just need to say in users repository and then extend it from the JPA repository. That's all. So this is an interface. I have extended everything from it. So imagine how much line of code I have written, right? If it was Java, I had to create a separate package. I have to annotate it with. I had to create a separate package. I had to say extend now. So that is not required. Same way for this users entity, I have to create getters and setters. I don't require any of these. Okay. So now, how do we inject this users repository into this particular users resource? So in Java, we do created a default constructor and made Spring MVC 4 to auto wire it automatically, right? So we can do similar thing, but we can do that here directly. So I can just directly, if you notice here, IntelliJ is already suggesting me what I can inject. So I'm just injecting users repository. So this is how you do auto wiring in Kotlin. Okay, and I can use that particular variable directly here, and I'm going to say find out. Okay, I'm just going to say return. So why is it giving an error for me? It's saying it's not able to access unresolved reference. I don't know why. Maybe I can try removing this from the class here and then trying to put it in a different class. Let's try, because I'm not sure. I didn't try this previously. So let's say users repository. I'll say interface. Okay, I will just remove this guy. Okay. Still it says unresolved. I don't know why is it saying unresolved? Okay, I think I know why. I think I have to put val. Okay, that's the reason. So I need to put val for the user repository. I think I don't even have to create a new file. I'll just scrap this file. Okay, let's reduce the number of lines of code which we write, right? Okay, so I missed that val option, sorry guys. So I had to create a val so that this is a value basically. So there are two types of variables, right? Val or var in Kotlin. So val is a final variable and var is like a variable which you can create and assign values at any point of time. Okay, so what I have done is I'm just creating a rest endpoint. I'll just give this rest endpoint name as all. Okay, slash all. So user slash all should now give me the list of users from the users repository to the user pack. Okay, now let's insert some value, right? So I'll say insert, and then I'll give some name. Okay, same way what we need to do is we need to say insert users. Okay, so we have some arguments here. So it's a path variable, so I'll just say path variable. Okay, and I just need to say name colon string. Okay, that's it. So my name has come. Now my return type will be again, let's say I am going to just return the same thing, the list of users. So what we are going to do is we are going to use the users repository and say save. Okay, and we need to create it, and while returning we are going to say users repository dot find all. So this users we need to create, right? So we need to create it. So we have to say users, and we need to pass the name, right? If we pass the name, it will be overridden with whatever we pass. And if we don't give the salary, it will be using 2000 itself. So I'm not going to give the salary here. Okay, so it will use the same 2000 itself. And same way, the ID will be generated as well. So I'm not giving the salary and ID. It will be automatically populated. Okay, ID will be automatically generated. It will not be zero. So we are going to see that as well. One more thing, if you notice here, this particular method, we are not doing anything extra here. So we are just returning the user's repository as find all, right? So Kotlin has the capability to identify what is the return type of this object and automatically add it here. So we can simplify this to this. So you can basically say get users and equal to users repository dot find all. That's it. So imagine the number of lines, right? It's gone. If you were writing in Java, you had to write so many lines of code. But if you see in Kotlin, you have to write very, very minimal line of code. Right? Okay, let's that's it, I think, right? Yeah, we have created a users repository. We have created a users. Yeah, we have created a resource. We have auto wired already. So this is the auto wire part. If you compare with Java, this is the constructor, basically. Okay, so let me start this application. So the number of lines of code which I have written is very, very minimal in Kotlin compared to Java. And also in Kotlin, if you notice, every class is final by default. And I think Spring Boot will not come up because Spring Boot requires this particular application class to be open. Let's see if it will be able to come up. But what we should be able to do is we should open this particular class. So what we have to do is we have to type open in front of the class to make it open. In our case, it is not required because we didn't add any configuration or something. But if let's say you are adding a Java configuration in Spring Boot to enable or disable some other functionality, you have to enable that particular class as open, so that particular class will be open for other classes to be modified. So Spring uses these reflections, and it uses this AOP CCB library, CC libs, right, to do some operations based on the classes. So in that case, you have to manually enable these classes to be open. So you have to add this open keyword in front of the class so that we can modify it. Okay, so if you see the Spring Boot application is up, let's go to the browser. So let me say users/all, right? REST users all. Yeah, I don't see any response. So what is the next REST endpoint which we created? We said insert and name, okay. I'll just say insert and I'll say Peter. Okay, if you notice here, the Peter got inserted and then it is queried back and then it has come. So let me add Sam. Yeah, both are coming. If you see here, Sam got added, but I wanted everything, right? So I just said user repository dot find all while returning the response, so I got everything back. So that is what is happening here. So if you notice here, this is the difference between Spring Boot and the Java. So in Kotlin and Java. So in Kotlin, you will have different syntaxes, but it is all running the same JVM. So you can use Spring Boot in Kotlin as well. There is no other major change. So if you see here, it's almost the same thing, right? The only thing is in Kotlin, we are writing very, very less code compared to what we wrote in Java. So that is the major difference between Kotlin and Java. So Kotlin is making life simpler, and it has good support for null checks and stuff like that. There are lots of features in Kotlin, but in this particular video, we just wanted to discuss the Kotlin usage in Spring Boot application. So this is how we use Spring Boot application for developing using Kotlin. Okay, so that's it for this particular video. If you like the video, go ahead and like it, share it, and comment if you have any doubts. Meet you again in the next video. Thank you.